Another missing number in the jungle. Turned up with nothing but a loincloth to protect your tender penis from what's danger in the wildlife. Your human nose making the least of all scent. Gone dumb, the dynamic of cleaning. Your bare feet cringing across the unkempt forest floor. Minutes ago, you'd been licking brass knuckle and soaking up satellite feed. Being crowned this year's champion king, looking good, bad, and a beautiful thing. Big winner of the only and any serious, serious guts competition. Sponsored in part, of course, by the pain reliever people on the Heavy Music Couch. Yes, you and 10 other tough guys slit smiles across your then perfectly sturdy stomachs and spread your large intestines boldly out across a coated white poker table. Pistol barked, and each contestant commenced to carefully comb their own eager entrails from behind the one-way wall of mirrored eyewear. Everyone a hopeful, breathing heavy, sifting through their mortal coil with their fingertips for the most intimidating lengths of well-sculpted and prime-time stomach aches. Every so often, in the name of health, an executioner cap dusher struts about the gut-covered table, misting everyone's exposed and heaving organs with a modified and fancy water pistol. As always, this year's celebrity judges are only of the most incredible persuasion. Charles Bronson's angry and gay little daughter, Ice Cube, back from when he was home, and a frame made by Dan and Joe Davis Lincoln. And because you love them, they stitch up your open abdomen first, gave you a nice rainbow knife, some choice cigarettes, and put you loose in the ozone. The question being not if, but when you will kill the next man. And besides, you have learned this before. In 1 month's time, they anticipate your turning up the apple of Lincoln Memorial, wearing stripped and cured flesh and other white. I never swung a wooden sword at slow beat. Kept something dying in a box beneath a bed my father's father built for me. Never fed a mare honey and seed from my hand, or held a harp. These things would melt me, and then they would have won me. Doth the dark procedure, in their swift and ample memory, simply humble a ledge, and lover. You were a mist before stained glass, its beauty never pointed at you. Yet you held on bare legs, curing body a dead-ended cat. Below Portland, beside the boulevard, you saw it suck flesh, pulled by days of dirt giving rain for a gentle second in its lower jaw. All that was soft to it now had life. I, cat, I, and it was beautiful before you. Made you cry and beg for what they entrust you. Made you cry and heart. Finally, you needed morals you could understand. The cold below all rules and human kind. The light before you in your boy. And you pricked your yet bigger finger. Beautiful looking bottle. And pricked your boyfriend into his mouth. Making a pack of debts that you could never make without a children. And were you asked at such a young age to spend a year of weeks beneath the earth asleep beside either of your grandfathers going gone? Talk to their husks with the weaves of your sleep child chest, and give them grace as they fall into a single.